and I'm doing my persuasive speech on texting and driving. This is for my Speech 101 class, instructed by Nicole Ackman. How many of you have texted while driving? How many of you have been caught texting while driving? One statistic that I found really interesting from my article, Texting and Driving, was that 13% of drivers between ages 18 and 20 involved in car wrecks have admitted to being on their mobile device at the time of the crash. Whether you are sending a text message, on your GPS system, or just talking on the phone, we are all guilty of using or operating a mobile device while we are driving. Texting while driving has become a growing trend in our society today, where drivers think they are texting and driving in a safe manner. Many teens and adults have engaged in this bad habit, leading to many accidents that may result in injury, death, and severe consequences. It has been researched that the minimal amount of time your attention is taken away from driving when you are texting is about 5 seconds. That is driving the length of a football field without looking at about 55 miles per hour. First, I would like to address the issue. Young teens are the big problem to this issue now, and you are starting to see adults engage in this activity as well. This is from my article called Curbing Texting While Driving. Texting has been compared to driving while intoxicated. It is said to be about 6 times more likely for a texting and driving accident to happen than it is those who are driving drunk. I got my information from the article called Because Texting and Driving Kills. Text messaging causes drivers to take their eyes off the road and one hand off of the steering wheel, causing them harm to themselves and to others. Texting and driving is the top reason for car accidents and deaths in the U.S. today. Research from my source, Because Texting and Driving Kills, states that 11 teens die every day from this bad habit. Due to this issue becoming more and more of a problem, states are starting to create a ban for this action for the safety of everyone. So some solutions that I came up with would be that it'd be mandatory to educate young drivers even before they receive their permit on the repercussions of texting and driving, such as them having to follow along a PowerPoint when they are doing their test, when they are trying to get their permit, or attending classes before they can actually have their permit. We want to look at the safety reasons for ourselves and the people around us. By having the no phone use while driving will help to decrease the numbers of deaths and injury in our society today. It is hard to create a law that so many are guilty of, and oftentimes they are unaware that they are engaging in this bad habit. So today, texting and driving is a growing trend in our society, while many claim that they are being safe when they are performing this action. Statistics have shown that texting and driving is worse and is the cause of most accidents rather than driving under the influence. Laws need to be enforced for the safety of everyone. And if you feel the need that you need to text somebody or respond to a text message or call someone, then it would be appropriate to pull off on the side of the road. Some statistics that I found about this problem would be 1 in 5 drivers of all ages confess to surfing the web while driving. 34% say they have texted while driving. 52% say they have talked on a cell phone while driving. 82% of Americans that are 16 or 17 years old own a cell phone. 77% of young adults claim that they are very confident that they can safely text and drive. Teens who text while driving spend about 10% of their driving time outside of the lane. 48% of young children have seen their parents talk on the phone, and 15% have seen them text while they're driving. 55% of adults claim that it is easy to text and drive. 48% of kids between the ages 12 and 17 have been in a car while driving, while the driver was texting. 27% of adults have sent or received a text message while driving. 23% of auto collisions involved cell phones in 2011, and that's about 1.3 million crashes. So I hope by this speech you see the statistics are relatable to us and we put a stop to texting and driving.